students, today we will learn that how a carburetor works. Okay, carburetor is a device used with SI engine. The job of carburetor is to make proper mixture of air and gasoline. Okay, generally carburetor is used with liquid fuels, and that is generally gasoline is used with automobiles for SI engines. Okay, so to make the proper mixture of gasoline and air so that it can perfectly burn inside the cylinder when the combustion happens, okay, that job is done by the carburetor. Okay, nowadays carburetors are replaced by MPFI system. Okay, it is an old technology for developing the proper mixture of gasoline and air, yet since the carburetors are cheaper in price, so still the use of carburetor is practiced in small automobiles, especially in two-wheelers. However, in cars, most of the cars are fitted with MPFI system. So here I will talk about that how the carburetor works. Okay, I will talk about the simple carburetor. Okay, this is the first made carburetor for automobile, for SI engines, first made carburetor. This is a simple carburetor. Okay, later on many modifications and improvement were done with simple carburetor in order to improve the performance and efficiency of it, but the principle remained the same. The principle of carburetion remains the same as that of simple carburetor is. Okay, but some modifications happened with this carburetor with time, okay, to improve its performance. Okay, so over here let's learn that how the carburetor works. Okay, first of all I will talk about that what are the different components of carburetor. Okay, here it is the schematic indicative diagram of carburetor. You can see this is a float chamber. Okay, as I am showing by the help of this arrow, this is a float chamber inside which there is a float valve. I will tell you that what is the job of this valve and what is the job of this float chamber. Okay, and you can see that there is an inlet to this float chamber. The gasoline comes from the petrol tank, gasoline tank. Okay, and ultimately reaches first of all to this float chamber. Okay, this is the venturi. It is generally cylindrical in shape. This is venturi. Okay, and you can see this venturi contains a throat with it. This is called as throat. Okay, so what is the difference between throat and venturi? You can see this is the diameter of venturi. It is cylindrical in shape. Okay, this is the diameter of venturi, but over the throat the diameter is lessened. Okay, and you can see that from here a very small duct is coming, very small thin pipe is coming from this throat chamber, and ultimately it is opening at the center of the throat. You can see if this is the throat region, and the opening of this jet is inside this throat region. Okay, like this. This is the throttle valve. Okay, the job of this throttle valve, it can open and close accordingly so that you can control the amount of mixture. See what happens, the mixture of gasoline and air is called as charge. So by opening and closing this throttle valve, you can change the amount of mixture going inside the cylinder. Okay, there's a choke valve. You can see this is a choke valve. Okay, and this is the air filter. The job of air filter is to, before mixing up with gasoline, okay, air passes through this air filter so that any dust and debris present in air can be screened off by this air filter. Generally it is a sort of spongy substance, so when air passes through it, then dust are screened off before entering inside this venturi. Okay, and this is the inlet valve of the cylinder. Okay, we know in case it is four stroke SI engine, then suction compression working in the exhaust. Okay, what happens in suction stroke? The inlet valve opens and the mixture of fuel and air goes inside. Okay, so here I am not showing the entire engine, just this is an indicative diagram. Okay, what happens, that air enters inside this venturi through this air filter, ultimately reaching this throat. In the throat the fuel mixes with air, and ultimately from here the mixture starts and ultimately ends inside the cylinder. Okay, when this happens, when the suction stroke executes, because we know this thing that in four stroke engine, if it is four stroke engine, then I am talking about in four stroke engine, the engine sucks the charge inside when the suction stroke executes. Okay, so whenever the suction stroke executes, the air passes through this air filter, reaches the throat. Here it mixes with the gasoline, ultimately enters inside the cylinder when this valve opens and suction stroke executes. Okay, now one by one I will tell you how these devices work. These are the main devices. Those are the float valve, the throttle valve, and the choke valve. Okay, what is the job of this float valve? The job of this float valve is to see what happens. Fuel is coming from the fuel tank and ultimately entering inside this float chamber. Okay, you can see this is the float valve. Actually, it is a thin shell which contains air inside it. Okay, means its mass is very, very less. It floats over the gasoline. Okay, because it is filled with air. Same as like that of balloon. In case an inflated balloon is kept over water, then it starts floating over it. So it is made up of very thin shell material. Okay, hollow shell and it contains air inside it. Okay, so what happens that it floats over the gasoline, and you can see that it's one of the part is closing this inlet of petrol. Okay, now how it works, that whenever the level of gasoline drops inside this float chamber, then it becomes like this. It also moves downward. So in that case, what happens? You can see now this opening is opened. So petrol start filling inside. Okay. So once this float chamber is filled with adequate amount of petrol, it again rises up by floating and ultimately closes that portion from where the gasoline is entering inside. Okay. So you understood what is the job of this float valve? That whenever the level of petrol inside this float chamber drops, then it also moves in downward direction. So in that case, this opening is opened and petrol starts going inside. Ultimately, when it is fully filled, then it rises up and closes that opening. Okay. Now, what is the job of this throttle valve? Okay. We can open and close this throttle valve like this. It is fully open. Okay. And like this, it is closed. Okay. So what happens? That amount of charge is controlled by this throttle valve. In case we fully open it, then more charge goes inside the cylinder, and in case we close it, okay, then less charge starts going inside the engine. So by the help of this, you can control the speed of engine. If it is fully open, then engine runs with highest speed, and if it is partially open, then according to its opening, the speed of engine is controlled. Now let's talk that how the carburetor works. Okay, suppose I say that suction stroke has come. Okay, suction stroke is executing, so inlet valve is open and the piston is moving in downward direction. It is creating a void vacuum inside the cylinder. So what will happen? To clear that vacuum, air will start passing through this air filter. Okay, like this, it is moving through the venturi and reaching this throat. Okay, so over the throat, you can see that cross-sectional area is less compared to that of cross-sectional area of venturi. Okay, so air is passing through air filter, through venturi, ultimately throat. So since at the throat the cross-sectional area is less, so by applying continuity equation, that is A1V1 equals to A2V2. Okay, so in that case, we know this thing that velocity is inversely proportional to the cross-sectional area. So here the cross-sectional area is less, so velocity will be high. So compared to that of the velocity over here, the velocity over the throat will be higher. And we know that Bernoulli's theorem says that in case velocity increases, then pressure decreases. So what will happen? Inside this region of throat, the pressure will decrease, and due to the decrement in pressure, it will pull some amount of gasoline from this jet. That's it, because the pressure has been reduced. Okay, so a puff of gasoline will be sprayed due to that reduction in pressure in the air. Okay, so those fine droplets of gasoline will ultimately mix up with the air and ultimately will be sucked inside the engine cylinder. That's it. This is what the principle of carburetor. And you can see, in case one line answer you want, then principle of simple carburetor is the Bernoulli's principle. Okay, so once again, what happens that whenever the suction stroke is executing, then piston is creating void inside the cylinder. So to clear that vacuum, the air will start moving through this air filter, okay, through this venturi, ultimately reach the throat. So over the throat, since the cross-sectional area is less, so the velocity will be high. So over there, since velocity is high, Bernoulli's theorem says that in case velocity increases, then pressure reduces. Due to that reduction in pressure, it will suck, it will pull some amount of petrol. Okay, and ultimately the mixture of air and fuel, that is charge, will go and enter inside the cylinder. Okay, and since some amount of petrol is sucked through this jet, so what will happen? That the level of petrol inside this float chamber will reduce. Okay, so in turn this float valve will also descend down, so fresh gasoline will enter inside and again the level will be maintained. That's it. Okay, what is the job of this choke valve? Okay, see that in default it is kept open. Okay, now what happens whenever an engine is cold, the cylinder is cold, especially in winter seasons, in that case it is seen that with normal amount of air fuel ratio, it doesn't starts up. Okay, for that problem, the rectification is that increase the amount of gasoline in the air. It means make the mixture rich. Okay, in case compared to that of adequate mixture, the amount of petrol in air is increased, in that case it's easy for the engine to start up. Okay, so how the choke valve is used? In default it is kept open. Okay, but when it is required to be used, then it is closed, and you can see that it is not fully closed, but the path of air is restricted. Okay, some area is still left so that air can pass through. Okay, so when the engine is cold, okay, I told you that with normal mixture it cannot run, it cannot start up. So what happens when this path is restricted and when the suction stroke is executing? Okay, so what is happening inside the cylinder? Vacuum is creating. So to clear that vacuum, air is required, but the air's
path is restricted. So what will happen? The cylinder wants to clear that vacuum. So since air's path is restricted, so it will pull the petrol, more amount of petrol, to compensate the amount of vacuum created inside. Okay, you can see normally when it is open, then this much gasoline is mixed with air, but in case it is closed, then more gasoline mixes with air. Okay, and reason I told that the path of air is restricted, so to clear that vacuum, more amount of petrol comes out from this jet and more amount of petrol mixed with the air. By this way, the mixture becomes rich. Rich mixture goes inside, it catches fire easily by the help of a spark plug. So in case engine is made to run by this rich mixture for some time, the cylinder becomes hot. After that, open the choke valve and engine starts running with the normal air fuel mixture. Okay, so this is how, by the help of a small explanation, I told you that how a simple carburetor works. Okay, thank you.